This is Tell Me What to Read, powered by Booktopia. I'm Nick Wasiliev, and today I get to sit down for two very special conversations. For those who are not familiar, the world of book talk is taking the book world by storm. So today I get to sit down with two book talkers, SquivReads and LondonApples, to talk about the books that they are reading and enjoying and introduce us to the crazy world of book talk. This is TikTok Made Me Buy It. I'm Nick Wasiliev, and today I'm back over the wonders that is, you know, Zoom, once again, here to do another podcast discussion. And today we're going to dive into the world of BookTok and TikTok. I am super excited today because I get to chat with a BookToker, which always makes me super, which I always absolutely love. And I'm joined by Oliva, aka SquivReads, who is here today to talk about all things books and BookTok. Oliva, welcome to Tell Me What to Read.
Hello, thank you for having me.
It is so nice to have you, and it is so lovely to, you know, to talk to fellow social media guests and hosts and everything around that. But I always am curious whenever I talk with people, you know, fellow lovers of books who you know work in a professional capacity or a working capacity online. Where did your journey with books start for you?
Well, in lockdown, the first big lockdown in Australia, a friend and I convinced her to read the A Court of Thorns and Roses series by Sarah J. Maas. And we ended up thinking, you know what, let's create a podcast. Let's go wild and make a podcast. And it lasted about 3 months. But in that time that we did it, we created a TikTok for our podcast. And then when we kind of stopped, I thought, you know what, let's just wing it and I will take over the TikTok and use it as mine. But I'd been lurking on TikTok for yonks before I started posting. But I love it. It's changed my reading tastes. I've made so many friends. I think it's terrific.
Yeah, I want to ask because probably a lot of people who listen to the podcast probably like they've heard of TikTok. They've heard of BookTok specifically, but they're like, how on earth is this machine that works like that is BookTok? Can you kind of try? I know it's like an impossible question to ask. Can you describe it in a nutshell what BookTok is for those who are not familiar?
BookTok is essentially a niche, well, maybe not so niche, but a community within TikTok where all these book lovers from all around the world are just posting content about all the books they love. It can be scenarios, quotes, reviews, just anything to do with books.
A great way I find people describe it is that it's essentially like the largest online book club you could potentially ask for. It's essentially people recommending other people books in very quick, succinct, fun videos, talking about book hauls, talking about everything like that. I'm curious, you mentioned that a lot of your tastes were changed from jumping onto BookTok. What did you originally go for and what happened?
Up until about 2020, I exclusively read like YA fantasy books, which is not what I read now at all. I kind of started seeing more fantasy books with romance pop up on my For You page for TikTok. So then I started, you know, reading those, and then it somehow just merged to now I almost exclusively read romance books with some new adult fantasy books. So definitely quite a drastic change within not a huge amount of time.
Well, it is still fascinating. I love how this space changes people's tastes and stuff. What do you like say or encourage people? Like, hey, we want you to actually go out and check out all the fun stuff that BookTok does, because you know it does. It's more than just talking romance and YA and everything around that. It's everything, isn't it?
Yeah, for sure. I think there's a lot of really intellectual discussions take part on TikTok, which sounds, some people would be like, what? But like, we talk a lot about, diverse book recommendations. And honestly, I think my favorite part about TikTok is just making friends and connecting with people. I'm quite an introverted person with a very small group of friends, but since I've joined TikTok, I have so many people that I can talk to like about books, and I love it.
Well, let's talk about books that, you've been reading, you've been recommending. Obviously, for all of our listeners, first of all, I'll include links to Liv's TikTok where you can go and check out all of the videos that she does where she, talks about books that she likes or talks about books that she enjoys. What books have you brought along that you've been reading?
I have a small stack that I'm very excited to share. First up, I have Take a Hint, Danny Brown by Talia Hibbert. I only discovered her books early this year. They're super fun, rom-com reads, diverse, just absolutely phenomenal. This is the second book in a series, so I'd recommend reading Get a Life, Chloe Brown, as before you read this one, but so, so good.
I love it. I'm not usually going for romance, but I actually, but like seeing how many books there are in the romance space, I often am like, wow, it covers everything.
Oh, for sure. There's something for everyone, I think.
Yeah. What else have you brought along?
The next book, I've made my whole personality recently. It's just one of those books that lives in my mind rent-free. It is Redeemed by Lauren Asher. I recently bought a copy. I'd read it on Kindle Unlimited originally, but I've been tabbing it. I've been buying merch. I've been posting about it nonstop. I read this book like a year ago, but it's in my brain. It's a Formula One sports romance, the fourth book in a series. I know, very niche kind of area, but so, so good. I laughed, I cried. There was just a lot of emotions.
So what is it that has made, I mean, obviously, for full disclosure, I just want to say to everyone, like, your byline online literally says addicted to sports romance and smut. So expect the niche. But what is it about this particular book that has made it take over your brain and go, wow, this, I can't stop thinking about it?
Look, I can't even really pinpoint what the reason is. I love Lauren Asher's books. She's a lovely human being. She just writes great books. And this one, I do not know what it is, but I think it was just very emotional for me reading it, even though it is kind of a rom-com read. But it has like a grumpy sunshine romance, which is my favorite, and fake dating, and just everything that makes me so happy when I pick up a book. And it just, I don't know, so many emotions, and I really connected to the main character, and it just was such a good book.
It ticks all the boxes.
Exactly.
I love it. I love it.
Next one, I've got another sports romance, From Lukov with Love by Mariana Zapata. It is a figure skating rivals to lovers slow burn. It is a bit of a chunky one.
Oh my God, it's a brick.
It is. It is. How many pages is it? I want to say maybe like, okay, it's 530 pages. I've read it multiple times. I've listened to the audiobook. I have it. I just, every format it comes in, I have it. I love it. It is the most ultimate slow burn I've ever read. Like, they're friends until maybe about here. And then they're like, hang on a second.
Oh no.
It's the ultimate slow burn, but I absolutely love it.
Oh, I absolutely love it. It's like, you can't leave me on tender hooks for 500 of the 530 pages. That's cruel.
I know, it's pretty intense. But that being said, I just love the character development that both the main characters go through in order to get to the place where they are together.
What is it about this particular, like, because I'm noticing a niche with the books that you're enjoying. What is it about this particular niche that like scratches your reading satisfaction itch for you?
Sports romance, yeah. Do you mean? Or
all of it.
Here's the thing. I like to think I can play a lot of sports. Can I? No. But when I was younger, I did. And I think like my little romantic heart secretly would love to be like the main character in one of these sports romances. I just think it's so fun. And I, like, before reading Redeemed by Lauren Asher, I had never watched a Formula One race before. And now I am religiously watching the real Formula One.
And yeah, are you caught up in all the storylines and everything in between?
Not all of them yet. I feel like I need to go on some more like Facebook groups and stuff to, you know, keep up to date on everything. But I will dabble in the viewing of Formula One, if you will. But I just, I don't know. I think it's great. I'm naturally a very competitive person. So I just love sports in general. And when I discovered sports romance, I was like, oh my goodness, all my prayers have been answered.
Oh, I love it. Absolutely love it. You have one more book for us.
Yes, I do. It Happened One Summer by Tessa Bailey. This book is so good. It has just taken TikTok by storm. And I hadn't heard of it before TikTok. Picked it up. Grumpy Sunshine. Slow Burn. It's based off Schitt's Creek, the TV series. So yeah, I know. It's just so fun. And I believe it's just been picked up to become a movie. So that's super exciting. I love it. I've started a Tessa Bailey collection along here. This was the first of her books that I read. Yeah, now I'm making my way across the entire backlist. So good.
Oh, so basically this is one to be like, okay, keep a watch of this. There's going to be an adaptation and it's going to, people are going to find out about it like the moment the movie comes out, and suddenly it's going to be sold
out in bookstores. I can already tell. It's just going to absolutely skyrocket.
I love it. And I love it's falling into that style. She is such a good writer.
I love it. And she's just such a fun and lovely human being in general. I religiously watch her TikToks. I think she's just so funny. I love her.
She really is getting stuff sorted out when it comes to author talk. Authors hanging out on TikTok, sure, and doing fun stuff.
She's absolutely nailed it. She's doing so well.
Yes, absolutely. And yes, there is a thing for everyone listening called author talk. You can go and find your favorite authors messing around on TikTok. It is a real thing. Thank you so much. I love those recommendations. I'm going to finish off with some fun kind of quick fire little questions. No right or wrong answers, just fun bookish scenarios.
I'm ready. Hit me. I'm a little nervous, but I'm ready.
You should be terrified. No. What is the perfect idea of a night with a book for you?
I am not a very exciting person, but okay, picture this. Bed, hoodie, massive cup of tea that just refills itself constantly, and just whole night reading, nothing else. No distractions, no nothing.
Perfect. Full marks, tick, tick, tick. Excellent. You get in a lift and the person that you have always wanted to meet in your life is in there. Who is it?
Is it a fictional character or a real person?
Can be fictional.
This is so hard.
I know. So many lovely protagonists to anyone could be in the lift.
When you said I should be nervous, you were absolutely right. I'm so bad at thinking on my feet. Okay, we're gonna go with a real person, Mariana Zapata. She's the author of my lovely stack here and From Lukov with Love. If I walked into an elevator with her, I would actually probably just pass out from just sheer overwhelmedness.
Thank God I didn't ask. Is that a word? Yeah, just like, oh my God, it's you.
It would probably, in my head, I would be freaking out and I would just stand there quietly as if it was a regular old thing. Like, you know, oh, I'm just in the lift with Mariana Zapata. But in my head, we're screaming.
Absolutely. Thank God I didn't ask the question of, you've got time for one question, what is it? You'd be passed out on the floor.
No, yeah, would not even be conscious for it. Would just be in the corner.
If you chat to someone and they're brand new to book talk, what is the first romance book or first author you direct them to? Specifically romance.
Does it have to be one? Can I give multiples?
Sure.
Anna Hung, who wrote the Twisted series. I love that series. It's a book talk staple. Absolutely amazing. It's fun, it's spicy, ticks all the boxes. And probably Lauren Asher as well, who did Redeemed, that book I recommended before. So good. Those are my two that I'd be like, read any of those books. Anything, you can't go wrong with them.
Oh, I love it. Obviously, getting into book talk is like huge. If you are an author that like has a book that is picked up in the world of book talk, you are basically a bona fide god on earth. We're talking like, you know,
oh, you're, for sure.
You're Emily Henry's, your Taylor Jenkins Reid's, your Colleen Hoover's equivalent. Is there a book that, you know, you love, that you would love the most to get swept up? It hasn't been swept up yet in the world of book talk, but it's like being slept on a little bit that people need to be aware of.
Good question. Okay. The Princess Trap by Talia Hibbert. I actually have never seen anyone talk about this book on BookTok, and it makes me so sad because it is one of my all-time favorites. And her series, The Brown Sisters, which I recommended before, massive BookTok staple. I don't understand why no one is talking about this. It is so, so good.
Oh, love it. Great response. Audiobook or ebook?
Ooh. Ebook.
Ebook. Interesting. Everyone always goes either audiobook. I'm curious why.
I love audiobooks, don't get me wrong, but ebooks, They just work really well for me. I have a Kindle and I take it in my bag with me everywhere I go, no exceptions. And it's just easier to, because I take a lot of public transport for uni and, you know, work and everything. And I just read on my phone or on my Kindle. Just makes things so much easier.
Love it. And then finally, classic last question. You are stuck on a deserted island. And while you await rescue, you get to take 3 books of your choice with you. What books do you take? And you cannot have book series. Only 3 books.
Oh my goodness. And I don't have a suitcase to like jam in as many books as I can, do I?
No.
I can only hold 3 books with me.
Only hold 3 books with you.
Oh, that's so hard. Okay. Oh my goodness, you're really going with the hard-hitting questions, aren't you?
It's the last one if it helps.
Okay, well, I'm taking Redeemed by Lauren Asher because, again, beautiful. Rent-free in my mind, can read it a gajillion times, will never get bored of it.
Good one. Ooh. Good start.
Okay, and then I'm taking Twisted Hate by Anna Hung. So good. Just Lauren Asher and Anna Hung go, like, hand in hand in my mind. So we got to have 1 of each.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I need to go with something adventurous that could teach me how to survive on this island. You know what I mean? Like, I need something that'll help me out a little. Okay.
I love how you're going with a practical. It's like, oh yeah, I'm going to take these 2 books and I'm going to live rent-free in my mind, but I also probably need to survive.
Yes. If I was actually like trapped in this scenario, I think I would be dead within like 24 hours, 100%. I'm not a very practical person. So I feel like I need something that would like teach me how to. I don't have a lot of fantasy books on my shelf, but I feel like I need to take a fantasy book with me.
Nice.
Okay, that's a lie. So I'm not taking a fantasy book with me. I'm taking Kate by Tate James. Bit of a spicy cover, but we can ignore that. It is a darker romance. Kind of, it's pretty, how do I explain this? It's quite an intense book. There's guns, there's knives, there's murder, I want to be the main character. I would never be able to, but in theory, she's really cool and I would be inspired by her to live on this island.
Oh, brilliant. I love it. Absolutely love it. I can honestly chat to you all day about books and book talks and everything and all fun trends and stuff going on, but unfortunately we have run out of time. But so I'll simply say, Olivia, thank you so much. It's been an absolute pleasure chatting books with you. Thank you for coming on Tell Me What to Read.
Thank you for having me. I've had such a great time.
It's been a pleasure having you. And for all of our listeners, you can go and check out Olivia, who's under the tag SquivReads on Instagram and on TikTok. Links to that will be included in the description. If you enjoyed our show today, drop us a review on Apple Podcasts or a like on Spotify. Tell us what you think. Let us know if you like our show or not. We want to hear from you. And if you are enjoying, you can also subscribe to our channel and also be notified whenever new episodes drop. Links, of course, in the description. Thanks for listening, and never stop reading. Now over to our second conversation with the one and only London Apples, who you can check out on TikTok right now. This is TikTok Made Me Buy It. This is Tell Me What to Read, powered by Booktopia. I'm Nick Wasiliev, and I'm excited today because once again we are diving deep into the world of book talk, and this is a small little segment or series that we're doing called TikTok Made Me Buy It. It's way too true in my life, in my case. Today I'm joined by Libby Ann, aka London Apples, who is here today to talk all things books, book talk, and book recommendations. Libby, welcome to Tell Me What to Read.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm super excited to chat.
It's really great to have you, and you're very welcome. And I just want to say, of course, we're recording in a podcast audio setting, so our audience can't hear it, but we'll put some assets and stuff on our TikTok and stuff. But I just want to shout out your glorious bookshelf that is behind you. If everyone, you can see it on her TikTok, so go check it out. I'll link to her TikTok in the description. But that bookshelf is amazing, and I'm loving the fact that you have a toothless right at the top up there, just like staring at me, and I love it.
Yes, he's watching over all the books.
How long did it take you to make this bookshelf? Because it is like, it's a work of art.
Yeah, oh my goodness. I have been collecting books for the last 8 years. So it's kind of just built since then. It's been a long process.
I absolutely love it. And I also want to shout out as well, If I'm currently just recording up at my partner's house, but if I was at home, I would be in my hoodie and be celebrating your hoodie game, because you often are like on your TikTok messing around on your hoodie as well.
Yeah, I should hoodie.
It's game recognizing game. It's hoodie. There is nothing better than like being in your hoodie and reading a book in bed or like equivalent.
Oh yeah, absolutely. With a cup of tea and it's the perfect day.
Yeah, have you got one of those things at home? I've got one of those like what are those like a cushion, but it's a cushion that actually has a space where you can fit your book on it. So it's like a book cushion so you can have a cushion on you and it's a space to read your book at the same time. Have you got like a funny little cool setup like that, or is it just tea, book, everything?
Yeah, no, I wish I did. No, I just hold my book. I've normally got like a cat on my lap, so they act as little like hand holding.
I love it. So tell me about your book journey. You mentioned you've been, you know, looking collecting books for the last 8 or 9 years. Where does your book journey start?
Yeah, well, I like first discovered reading and books when I was like at school. It was when I first like kind of went into high school and I was like, I really don't want to be around people. So I went and hid in the library, and that's where I found like the first book that I like became obsessed with. And it was like Throne of Glass. And then that's kind of like where it began. I like read all of those books and then I branched off into other series and then I just blew up from there. But I didn't actually start posting and like getting content onto social media until like 2020. So I was kind of like on my own for a while there. I didn't really have many friends or family that read books. And so jumping into that world and like getting all of the recommendations online was insane.
I will say, like, you've now got 120,000 followers on TikTok as a result. So that worked out all right. Talking books and talking about that space. I love that you started with Throne of Glass. Like, shout out to Sarah J Maas. Yes, please. Is fantasy the genre that you normally go for, or are you one of those people that I don't take sides? I just go for whatever is put in front of me.
I can kind of just go all around. Fantasy is like number one for me. It's my favorite. But more recently, I've been reading a lot more like contemporary and romance books. But I'm kind of like in between those two genres. They're my two go-to.
I love it, and I think it's so cool that we're talking about not just like romance, but also just how that space is influenced on BookTok. So, 'cause for everyone who isn't familiar with the concept of BookTok, and we do have some listeners who go, what the hell is this strange thing? It's essentially just become the word of mouth online recommendation for the modern age, really. How do you find navigating the world of BookTok? I'm assuming there would be a lot, you'd be getting recommended books and stuff all the time. It would be just being flung at you from every direction.
Oh yeah, absolutely. I have an endless list that I'm always like just putting in my notes from my comment section where they're like, you need to read this, or you need to read this. But it scares me. BookTok scares me because there's just so much out there. And I'm just like, oh my goodness, this is overwhelming. But I've found that for me, I don't think I would have read as much romance books or gotten more into that genre if it wasn't for BookTok, because I was so set in my ways with fantasy. I was like, there is nothing better than this. But then once I made some friends on BookTok and they were like, no, you need to start reading romance, I was like, oh, okay, like I actually enjoy this. So it's like, it's scary and overwhelming, but once you kind of find your way on there and meet some people, it's really good.
Absolutely. And I completely get how daunting it might be, because I mean, we do this, we're doing this with like from a professional, like the book seller angle. But for context for everyone, in May of this year, there were 45 billion hits on BookTok, like total. And then by July, it was like 65 billion. It's ridiculous how quickly it is growing. I also love that you talk about you would be pushed towards genres that you normally wouldn't go to. I found like that quite similar. I always kind of started as a literary fiction enjoyer. Like I would always go for my literary reads or something like that. But then everyone would say, no, you've got to check out this crime book. You've got to check out this fantasy book. You've got to check out this, you know, this book about this book about that. And I've now, as a result, gone on a massive crime reading spree, which has just kind of gone, thanks a lot, Booktop. Now all of my time is taken up by by recommended books, which is absolutely insane. Was there a book that originally it was recommended to you on BookTok and you were like, nah, that sounds absolutely out of my league. I will not pick that up I will not touch that with a barge pole. And then you actually did picking it up and just ended up really loving it.
You see, that's my issue. I will see a book that has a bunch of hype around it and they're like, this book's amazing. Everyone needs to read it. And I'm like, no, I won't like that. And one of those was the Atlas 6. I was like, everyone was recommending. I saw it everywhere. I couldn't scroll two videos without seeing a recommendation book. And it annoyed me so much that I was like, I will not buy it. I bought it. And I was like, I read it. And I hate that I love it so much because I was so set that I was like, no, I know what I like and it is not this book. But I did. I loved it.
It does have that impact. It is that infectious doing that, kind of being on that space and seeing so many people recommending books. Often there are so many people who are not familiar with the concept of book talk. What do you say, to people who kind of aren't familiar with it, to kind of encourage them to say, hey, if you actually try to engage with it, for example, this is something that actually is really worth your time?
Yeah, absolutely. No, I found that when people are kind of like what is book talk, I have to kind of first explain it's an app where people share their content and recommendations for different books and series, and you kind of make your own little community of people, almost a book club, your own little personal book club, and it's worldwide as well. You're not just making friends in your own little hometown. It's everywhere. So people come together from all different kinds of places with all different information and different books. So it's a worldwide book club in your own home.
I love that. That's one of the things I absolutely love about the whole BookTok space is that you will discuss and talk about books that you would previously never have, because there is suddenly you're seeing different people and interacting with different spaces. And you might be talking with someone over in London, over in New York, in South Africa, and you'll be talking about the same book that brought you the same joy or a different kind of experience. It's kind of a very, yes, everyone can talk is all about, oh yeah, the online space can be somewhat separating, but really it actually is essentially very much similar to a standard book club.
Yeah, and I found that what shocked me most about it is that reading is, a lot of us are all extreme introverts. We don't go outside. We'd rather be reading a book. So making friends, I've found online through books, is extremely easy and not as daunting as you would first think it is, because as soon as you have that one book that you both love, you could go on for hours talking about it, and it's just an instant click with that person, and it's like, oh, you're my new best friend.
I love that stuff as well, even being drawn to people that would surprise you. I would chat with some of the most, from their online space, seeing they seem the most loud extroverted, they go off and doing crazy adventures and being great and all of that, but then they'll come and sit down with you and say, oh no, I love this really quiet book about two people falling in love, or I really couldn't get enough of this, the Evelyn Hugo. And you would think, how did you have time to sit down and enjoy that? It's been I find it quite stereotype breaking as well, because it shows that anyone can be interested in any book and people can surprise you. It's I love that sort of stuff. We're at that stage in the podcast where we live up to the namesake of Tell Me What to Read. And I am absolutely giddy to know what books you have brought along to talk about with us today. What are you reading at the moment and enjoying?
Well, at the moment, I'm jumping between my contemporary and fantasy. I was I've got to have a good mix of both, because I love both genres. But my go-to recommendations at the moment for my contemporary romance books is obviously Colleen Hoover's November 9. I love her and all of her books, but this book is just, it's god tier. I love it. It gives massive, like, Love Rosie vibes, which I'm obsessed with that kind of, like, a storyline. And I love it. I'm a sucker for a good romance book.
Yeah, it's, Colleen Hoover is just the queen of everything. She's the queen of book talk. I'm so curious about why, because you did a TikTok recently about listing your favorite Colleen Hoover books. Why this particular one? Why is November 9 the upper echelons for Libby?
I think it's because it goes over a period of years. It's not just like we've got like 2 months to get to know these characters and see them fall in love. It's like you go through grief, you go through growth and happiness. It's like over a period of like a long period of time. So we get to see so much more of the characters and how they grow as a person and then as a couple as well.
Mm. Yeah, it's like it shows love, warts and all, but also like the kind of love that we are all looking for, which is the end of like life-spanning love and commitment, which is just kind of infectious.
Yeah, absolutely.
What else have you brought along?
Okay, well, I've got another one, which is more recent, Twin Crowns.
Mm-hmm.
I was shocked that I loved it so much. It's like a mix between a good fantasy book and a rom-com because it's super lighthearted. So it's like you've got that fantasy aspect with like the witches, but then you've also got like the princesses and the princes. And it's like, have you seen the movie? Lindsay Lohan's in it.
Hang on. Let me try and Google it. Parent Trap. Yes, The Parent Trap. Yep.
That's fun, yeah. So it's like a mix of Parent Trap, but in a like fantasy aspect because they're the twins. One's royalty and one was taken at birth and like trained as a witch. And then Ooh. She overthrew her sister and to get to be queen. So it's like, and it's hilarious. I laughed so much during this book. I've got so many different tabs.
I was about to say, like, I'm shouting out to the amount of tabs that you've got in that book. That looks like a very well-loved book.
Absolutely. It was so funny and lighthearted, but I loved that it also had that like darker aspect to it. It was like the perfect mix. They did awesome with this book.
I think that's one of the best things you can ask for with fantasy when it covers all forms. So it's not just, you know, you've got the light and the sheer magical nature of that space, but at the same time, it's real. There are real things and real consequences, which are amazing too.
Yeah, absolutely. Another one, like Emily Henry, she's pretty big on book talk as well, like Colleen Hoover. But book lovers got a huge amount of hype around it on the app. So I was terrified going into reading it because I was like, oh no, if I don't like this, I'm going to be so sad. But it was awesome. Another one that has like an insane amount of tabs in it. I was laughing so much. The romance was adorable.
There is something about her writing. It's just like, it's just filled with so much warmth and mirth and everything. It's absolutely glorious. And it makes me just go, oh, in every way, shape and form. Are you excited for her new book, by the way?
Oh my goodness. Yeah. It's coming even April, I think. I'm so excited. She's one of those authors that I see it in the bookstore and I'll buy it if I don't have it, like without even hearing anything about it. I'm just like, yep. Sold.
Out of curiosity, do you have I'm now going to suddenly throw this on you. Are you going to make a TikTok about your favorite Emily Henry reads from and would book lovers be at the top?
Ooh. Okay, I should. I didn't even think of that. I definitely should make a video because I've got almost all of her books. But yes, I think book lovers would be at the top. As much as I love all of her other books, there was something about this that just made me so happy. So I think yes, it would definitely be at the top.
Oh, I love it. It leans into that whole enjoyment of that space. She is so much fun, and I love just the stuff that the way that she writes. She's an absolute joy.
She's awesome.
Mm.
Another fantasy book. I mentioned the Atlas Six before, I think, but this one this one was awesome. I was obviously scared to read it because so many people loved it, and I was like, nope, not gonna read it. But when I did, I was obsessed. It's like a group of like six insane like magicians that are like forced to go to this school, and then basically they're pit against one another, and so not all of them are going to make it out at the end. But it was awesome. Again, super weird. Another character's name that was Libby. Where I never knew my name in books, and then I read these two like back to back, and I was like, this is weird.
Oh, I love it. So is it like a magical Hogwarts? Or is it like, hang on, no. Do you remember that show on ABC, like from like ages and ages ago, where it was like competitive, The Worst Witch? It was like one of those really competitive magical shows. This is a real throwback. like where it's like witches that are all in competition with each other to try and be like the top of the class or whatever. Is it kind of like that space, or is it a bit more like, oh no, there's like actual real consequences to the world that you're growing up?
Pretty bad consequences. Like, it's a really like dark, like a twisted magic school, but a really small magic school because there's only like six of them. but it's pretty dark. Like, it's not like a light-hearted funny read. It's got a lot of depth to it, so it's definitely more for mature readers, I would say. Like, I wouldn't throw this to someone that doesn't read fantasy. Like, yeah.
Oh, absolutely love it. TikTok will shame me for not knowing enough detail about that particular book. it sounds like perfect TikTok sort of space. I love it.
Absolutely, yeah. Jennifer L. Armentrout, she wrote From Blood and Ash. Mm-hmm. That's probably what she's like more known for, but I love her book series, The Harbinger. Storm and Fury is the first one in that series.
Love it.
Have you heard of that one?
I am familiar with it. Have not read it though. I'm loving that every single one of these books that you've got here, you've got like post-it note after post-it note after post-it note in it.
Yeah, they're all tabbed insanely.
Before you dive into Storm and Fury, I'm actually now curious, how do you post-it note every single book? Like, do you have a color coding scheme? How do you do it?
Yes. Well, I've got like a bunch of these different tabs, but all of the colors mean something different. So yellow, I will put a tab in if it's made me laugh or made me smile. Green is a quote that I want to remember or like come back to. Pink is a cute moment between the characters. And then what's another color? Orange was an insanely powerful moment in the book. And blue obviously is kind of like made me sad or if I cried. And purple is foreshadowing. So I use that one more so in like long series. And then I come back and I reread those purple tabs like, and kind of see how it linked in further on in the series.
Ooh, I'm going to have to steal some of this. This is genius. This is like proper, like next level reading. I just read it and just go, oh my God, this is amazing. I need to come up with a color coding system. This is amazing.
I find that it's a really good way to kind of come back and revisit the world or the book without having to read the whole book. Like, I can kind of just go back and go, cool, I want to kind of see all of the happy moments, or I want to go back and read some quotes. And then it's like, I don't actually have to read from front to back. It's just like a couple sections here and there.
Smart. I love it. Okay. I'm sorry. I've sidetracked us enough. Tell me a bit. Tell me about Storm and Fury.
Yeah, Storm and Fury. So it kind of, we follow Trinity. And what was awesome about this book is she has a eye condition called retinitis pigmentosa. So she's like slowly going blind. And you don't see that much in fantasy books, like a character that's got like a blindness. At least I haven't. But it was awesome to read because like my family, we all have that same condition as well. So she's like a grown up in a home of wardens who are all like demon hunters, basically. And then they find out that all demons and wardens are being hunted, and it's kind of just about her trying to figure out the problem and solve it with like a bunch of other wardens and stuff. Yeah, but it's awesome following her journey through this one. It's a trilogy as well, so there's two other books.
Oh my God. So basically, if you go down this one, you will be locked in with a thrilling cliffhanger and everything in between that makes you go, God darn it, I need to go and read this now. And then you'll go on a 12-hour marathon.
Yes, absolutely.
Say goodbye to that night's sleep for me. I love it. Any more books?
I do, actually. I've got one from last one is The Prison Healer, Lynette Noni. I saw you guys did a podcast with her and I loved it.
She is amazing. All hail Lynette Noni.
Yes. No, I first read the Madoran Chronicles, which was her one of her first book series. But this one was next level. Like at the end of every book in this trilogy, I was like, what? You know, that this woman knows how to do a cliffhanger. I was shocked. But yeah. No, this one was, it was awesome. And the fact that we were in a prison, it's like a more confined space throughout this book. It was intense. I loved it.
She is so, like, I'm amazed how quickly she was able to pump out this series. First and foremost, she is a machine that she like released the three books in 2 years or whatever it was. But on top of it, every single book, God darn it. Like,
it's insane.
Yeah. And the characters are so fascinating. And on top of it, like I'll try and keep it relatively spoiler free for everyone listening, but just the kind of the dynamics between all of these characters and this world filled with magic and everything in between is just, oh, wow. It does cover some really incredible ground for, you know, just for, you know, like a small, like a fantasy kind of aimed at, you know, YA sort of audience. It's an unbelievable book. Before I continue on with the podcast, in the most spoiler-free way possible, how much did that ending blow your mind?
I am a very oblivious reader. So even if there's like foreshadowing, I'm not going to like piece it together. So I was literally sitting on the couch and I was just like, for a solid like 5 minutes, I like went back and reread the last page like 5 times.
Yep. She has that impact. Lynette, if you're listening, shout out. We think you're amazing. Please keep being amazing at what you do. And I'm so excited to see what she gets up to next. Everyone go read the Prison Healer series. This is heavily endorsed by Libby and myself. And I actually, you know, it's a good thing where I recommended it to a friend of mine and she read the entire series in about, I think, like 10 or 11 hours. She just kind of just mowed through it. It was unbelievable. Yeah. Yeah. She read the first book and said, okay, now I'm going to have to go and buy the other ones. And I can't wait. I need to get the ebook. I need to get it all. And I need to read it now. amazing recommendations. I love that. I love where you're pulling from. I love what you're reading. It sounds absolutely fantastic. We'll finish off with some final quickfire questions, some kind of fun, kind of bookish questions. First up, what is the perfect idea of a night with a book for you?
The perfect idea. Well, I always have to have like a TV show playing. So I'd probably chuck on some Criminal Minds. I would be on my couch with whichever book I was reading, with some pizza and a cup of tea. Nice.
Good snack choices. I appreciate decent snack choices. You get into a lift. And the person, and I'm fully aware that I'm asking an introvert this, but that's okay because we all have fans that we love. You get into a lift and the person that you have always wanted to meet is in there. Who is it?
Can they be fictional?
Of course. They can be whatever you want.
Oh, okay. Awesome. Because I was like, I really don't want to meet another person.
I respect that.
They would be Dorian Haviland.
I like that. On the subject of that, you've got time for like one question to ask them before they get out of the lift. What would you ask?
Marry me?
Yeah, we're on the same page. I like it. That's the thing I would say. No, a part of me would also be like, what floor are you going to? I can get out with you and talk to you some more.
Yes, I should have thought of that. That's a good one.
So you have Someone you respect, close friend, whatever it may be, has jumped onto BookTok. It's their first time on BookTok. They're really enjoying it. And they come to you for recommendations. What is the first book, your go-to BookTok book, that you would direct them to?
Throne of Glass.
Throne of Glass. Love it.
Good one.
I love it. Yeah.
I feel like with BookTok as well, you've got to get out like the big series before it gets spoiled for you.
Oh, God, yeah. Trying to avoid spoilers on BookTok is like terrifying because you're always like, I'm currently in the middle of just like scrolling and scrolling like crazy, but one TikTok could ruin everything.
Yeah. When people start commenting spoilers on your posts, it's difficult to avoid.
That sounds like it happened to you, and if that's the case, I am so sorry. Now I'm actually curious. Which books have been spoiled for you by BookTok, and who should be shamed?
The Shadow and Bone trilogy was spoiled, which is really sad because I was reading it at the time.
Oh no!
Yeah, but that one, Shadowhunters. I've had a few spoilers for Shadowhunters. People tend to name drop, like if I make a video and I go, oh my goodness, this book, my favorite character died, then they go, oh my goodness, that's like when this person died, and I was like,
don't do that to me.
Yeah, but those are the main two that I was super upset about when they were spoiled.
God dang it. Well, BookTok, be better, be nice with spoilers, put like a spoilers ahead or spoiler warning in your comment before you comment. Don't break my heart. So obviously you read a lot of books. You have a beautiful, massive book wall behind you. You've been collecting books for many years. What book you love the most is currently, what is there a book being slept on in the world of BookTok that you think of it and you go, that is a book that deserves more attention?
I feel like there's like a few options for this because everyone tends to lean towards the books that you hear a lot about because people are like, oh, I want to be a part of that. I want to be a part of that massive fandom. But now I'm like, what books are like deserve more hype? This one I haven't actually seen it on BookTok myself. Snow Like Ashes. It's another trilogy.
Nice.
I feel like it's definitely an old one, so I'm not surprised that it hasn't, like, blown up at all. But this one, I feel like it didn't get enough hype when it was released, and it definitely deserves it. I haven't read it in years, though, so I definitely need to reread it, but I just remember being obsessed with it. It was, like, one of the first books I read after reading Throne of Glass, and it kind of got me out of that slump. So that's why I'm like, okay, it deserves hype, because if it can get me out of a slump after Throne of Glass, that's, like, that's big points.
I've never heard of it. What's it about?
Good question. So it's like it's like a fantasy. So she is like, she was orphaned during a war, and she is raised as a warrior, and they kind of travel in like this rebel pack, and they're like the last remaining rebels, and they kind of, I believe they plan on like overthrowing the like corrupt kingdom or something along those lines. Yeah, but it's a trilogy as well, so it's awesome.
Another one to get lost in. God dang it, you're killing me. My TBR pile is like the size of the up to the roof now, so okay, so I've got a Colleen Hoover question.
Mm-hmm.
Your house is on fire. Which Colleen Hoover book do you grab? And you cannot have November 9. You can't have November 9. Or assume November 9's already been saved, okay, but you need another one.
I would pick Heartbones.
Nice.
Yeah. They were probably the next two characters that I connected with the most. A lot of the books, like, even if I rate them lower on my list, it doesn't necessarily mean they're bad. It's just I didn't connect with the characters and their story as much. But Heartbones, I loved them both. And it felt like I was on holidays reading that book. It was awesome.
Love it. Good pick. Toothless from How to Train Your Dragon is on your bookshelf. But
he
then lands at your door and then tells you and tells you in his dragon way that he does, that he can take you to any fictional world of your choice. Where do you go?
Now I've thought about this. But I've also gone, do I want to survive? Because I feel like if I was thrown into a fantasy world, I would die pretty quickly. I we all know that side character that suddenly gets a lot of attention and then they're killed off. That's me. I am not there. But I would want to go, I'd want to go to the world of Throne of Glass, like Terracine, see that world. Like that's, I feel like even if I died, I would die happy because I got to see the Aelin's court. Like,
that's a good one. I like that. It's I think that's you basically picked a like probably, yeah, I'd go there as well. That's a lot of fun. Imagine if we could get Sarah J. Maas to be like, hey, do you want to jump into this world? Go, boom.
Oh, die. I love her. She's super nice.
Audiobook or ebook?
Ebook.
Ebook. Nice. Got to be practical. And then finally, classic last question.
Mm-hmm.
You are stuck on a deserted island, and while you await rescue, you get to take 3 books of your choice with you. What books do you take?
I would take November 9.
Yep, knew that one. I was almost tempted to be like, so we'll start with November 9.
What other books would I take? Okay, my other two, I would take Empire of Storms, and I would take probably Addie LaRue.
Oh, nice. Well, I'm curious. Why would you just for getting lost in the world during this dire situation that you find yourself in while awaiting rescue, or is it just for fun?
Yeah, no, it's a big book, and it would take me a while to read.
Smart.
Take up some time.
Good time passer. I like that. I could honestly chat to you all day about book talk and book recommendations, but unfortunately we are a podcast and we have to wrap it up. So I'll just simply say, Libby, thank you so much for chatting on Tell Me What to Read and telling us about all the amazing books that you have been reading and enjoying.
Yeah, no, thank you so much for having me. I love talking books.
Yay. So if everyone listening, you can check out Libby or London Apples on Instagram and on TikTok. I'll include links in the description below. And if you enjoyed our show today, you can drop us a review on Apple Podcasts or a like on Spotify. Tell us what you think. If you like the book recommendations, let us know. We want to hear what you have to say. And if you are enjoying our show, you can actually also subscribe to our channel and be notified whenever new episodes drop. Links in the description. Thanks for listening, and never stop reading.